welcome back to our channel. We are Chase and Melia, and today we are reacting to Siti Nurhaliza once again.
Woo-hoo!
This was a video that was sponsored, actually, by our friend Muhammad. So if you like this video, please be sure to thank Muhammad.
If you guys would like to sponsor a react video, meaning you want to request a very specific video and you want us to react to it
right away,
then you can check out the link below from our website, and you can do just that and request a video just like this. Now, before we get into the reaction video, we did want to inform you guys that we are starting a new live class. Are you guys just not getting enough reaction videos from us? If that's you, come join us on October 2nd. October 2nd will be our first class. This class will be free. We're doing this over on Livespot, so we'll leave the link to our Livespot below in the description box. There you'll get all the information and all the details, and it's going to be a surprise who we're reacting to on this class because we want you guys to show up. So we're reacting to somebody live. You guys can ask questions. You can interact and engage, and we might even feature some of you on our live class. So if you guys are interested in that, please check out the link below, and we will see you on October 2nd.
Okay.
Ready?
Yeah, so we're only 48 seconds in, but I have to say, I love microtonal.
Oh my gosh,
like,
yeah.
Music.
Oh, absolutely.
And this is one of the cool thing like about the voice is that you don't have to tune it.
Right.
And we as singers can have so much control where we can go intervals as tiny or as large as we want. And we, you know, other instruments, you kind of have to tune it to that, you know, kind of style.
Yeah.
Where you have, it has to be able to like slide and stuff.
And I don't think, like, I don't know if it doesn't make sense what Chase just said, another way to think of it is like, let's look at a keyboard, right? Like a piano keyboard. So the best example I can think of is if you look at notes B and C, so there's no black key in between them. That means that they're as close as you can possibly get. It's a half step. But when you look at a voice or even a stringed instrument, I guess horn instruments too, you can really get all the microtones in between those two notes. Now, in Western music, we don't do that. In Western music, we just play the notes.
We have 12 notes.
Yeah, we have 12 notes. Sometimes
notes,
you do slides and stuff like that where, yes, you hear and you make a sound on those notes, but you're not usually singing with those notes in a melody, you know, on purpose.
And that's what I mean by micro tones.
Absolutely.
You know, it's just a little bit sharp or a little bit, you know, moving up or down.
Yeah.
And it's so good because it's that's what, you know, when you hear it, you know, in Western culture, we would hear it in like a movie or something as like a, you know, an effect of being so exotic and different.
Right, right. Absolutely.
But it's just to the point, I played in a Balinese gamelan ensemble when I was in college.
Yeah.
And it was so much fun because it was a sound that I had never experienced before in my entire life.
Unique, yeah.
And it was so different from everything I've ever done. And I learned that, you know, every piece in there was tuned to each other and it was all one instrument.
Right.
And it was like, it was just such a cool thing to branch outside of these, you know, Western culture music.
Right.
Because it is so different and it is so gorgeous.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
I think we should do a little bit more research. I mean, we studied this a little bit in school, but I wonder what it's like to learn music like this, like as you grow up. Like, is it just something you learn by ear, or is it something that like you're taught, like this is, you know, are you taught scales, are you taught I'm sure it's both.
Please let us know in the comment section how, if you learned this music growing up, how you did it. Was it all by ear?
Right.
Is there a bunch of notation?
Right.
You know,
and how is it notated? Yeah.
Like, this is super interesting.
Right. But I would say, if we're talking about her voice, it's so beautiful and like I want to. We're gonna keep
really
listening.
Precise,
really precise,
super precise.
Yeah. From a vocal perspective, that is a very difficult technique for somebody who is not used to doing that. Like, it could sound super sloppy, don't you think? Like, it's a lot. It's like, similar to like a yodel, which we've talked about before.
Yeah. If we tried to do that, it would sound super sloppy.
Because if you were to look at what she was doing, like if we notated it in a Western style, right, mm-hmm. and we wrote down the notes, at least from what we could hear, mm-hmm. it would be really fast. A lot of notes really fast, right? There would be a lot of like trills and accent notes. And in order to do stuff like that, which is just like singing a run or coloratura or whatever, you have to have a super loose throat. You have to have a really yeah. relaxed throat, and you can hear that she has that because she's like, it's, she's singing with such ease.
Yeah, it's
and she's, it's effortless for her.
And it's really hard to have super loose and super precise. We
right.
talked about that with Fosia.
Yeah.
And having that looseness, but also being able to, you know, go up as just enough
yeah.
to make those little those yep. little
melismas, right?
There.
Yeah,
it's just so good.
It's so good. Yeah. I'm sorry, I had to stop because it is just really impressive what's happening too. Cindailah mana tidak berkias jalinnya rentah. I noticed her, she did the same thing that we talked about last time where she kind of like, it was the beginning of the song and she kind of like pulls back her energy a little
yeah.
bit, and it feels like it's almost kind of like the nature of the
phrase,
the style.
Style.
Yeah, because we've talked about this too in a lot of other, I mean, foreign languages to us because we're native English
sure.
speakers, but like languages that have a little bit more nasal quality.
Mm.
And when they have that nasal quality, it kind of forces you to do things differently than you would with in a different language. So for example, like when you sing on an it closes your resonance.
Mm-hmm.
And so that automatically changes the resonance just by the language. And
yeah.
so I feel like there were a few phrases there. I'll play it again, but you can kind of hear it goes like,
oh,
know what I mean? But I think it's also to the style, the scale a little bit, but also the language.
Yeah.
And I noticed that she was doing that when she, I think she was singing English
yeah.
last time.
I think that
yeah.
anybody who sings should sing this E vowel that
Oof.
She does here. That's the vowel.
Yeah.
That's what you need to go for.
Yeah.
At least, you know, in terms of what I teach.
Right.
Just because that's what cuts. That's the clear tone. It's just, it's, and it's easy. Right?
Yeah.
It's E.
Yeah.
And it's super easy. And she's, yeah,
she's also
awesome.
Having a great time.
Yeah,
which is
that's
really
good
fun
time.
To watch.
She's so good at singing
she's
with a
so
smile.
She's so good at singing with
I'm
a smile.
I'm awful at singing with a smile. I go like this.
That's so funny.
And I sing like this.
Like he's really
Maybe like
angry.
This. Sometimes. Malia is really good at singing with a smile, and I'm not.
Well.
There you go.
Can you blame me? Thank you.
it's like a tiny, really fast crescendo every time. That's so cool. That's so cool.
I'm like amazed at this just because it's so, it's impressive vocally. Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
It's impressive. Absolutely. And it's also really pretty. Like
it's really pretty.
It's really pretty. It's really pretty. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Going on there? Do you think she, so when you do that like it kind of almost cuts out
it
entirely.
Does almost, yeah, to me it seems kind of like a vibrato effect, kind of like it's,
do you think it's happening in the glottis, or do you think it's an air kind of, she pulls back her air to the point where it stops and then continues?
That's a good question. Let's listen to it real quick again, just that last part, right? It sounds a little glottal because to me, I hear it almost sounds like the vowel is changing,
sure,
but it's changing in her throat, not in her mouth. So like, sure. So you know what I mean? Yeah. Like you can change things in back here. That's not like, so it sounds, so that to me would say that it's kind of a glottal thing. And I think to me, it seems again, like vibrato is something that we do stylistically in Western music, like in musical theater, you do straight tone and then big vibrato. In classical music, like opera, you do vibrato all the time, you know what I mean? But in like other things, you do straight tone. So it seems a little bit like maybe it's a style type thing.
Oh,
like
definitely.
That. Yeah.
I'm always curious about how singers are doing stuff.
Absolutely.
We in the past have like compared two different singers, like with a K-pop group, and they're both amazing singers, mm-hmm. but they're doing things very differently.
Yep.
And I think that's, you know, it's a really, to me, I'm just a curious kind of singer where
absolutely.
I'm like,
yeah.
How are you doing that?
Yeah.
And I think you're right. I think that what I hear too is a little bit where I imagine it'd be much easier and you'd have much more control if you were doing it in the throat
right.
rather than in your belly.
Right.
You know, we have our own opinions on how that might tire your voice out more, mm-hmm. but she's doing just fine, and I'm not going to tell her how to sing.
And sometimes I wonder if it's different because of the, like, the training and, like, the nature of what she's doing. It seems
appropriate to the
style.
It seems
more natural, though,
too.
Also. Like, the technique seems more, like, you don't hear a lot of, like, in, like, contemporary pop, Western pop music, there's a lot of, like, bringing the chest higher up and creating a sound that maybe doesn't exist naturally. This doesn't sound like that. This sounds like she's singing in that spot. It's like folk music. So you're just singing wherever your voice sits in that particular note.
Yeah.
Or for that particular note. And so I would say, overall, it seems like a pretty healthy.
She seems like she's talking.
Yeah.
Yeah, it seems very healthy.
Right.
Seems very healthy.
Yeah. Cool. Awesome. Let's keep going.
So tough. da 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 da.
I know.
That is so good.
So good.
Ooh.
Yeah.
La 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 la. That's like five notes. It's really tough to get all of that.
Let's try it. Try it again. Sorry.
Ah.
Nice job. Ah. That's hard. Ah. I'm missing one. What are the notes?
Your little bum ba. That one is a little bit. There you go. There you go.
It's hard.
Well, and she does it like 20 times.
Yeah.
And she does it a bunch of
over
times.
Over and over again.
Over in a row. And it's really good.
Really nice.
Really nice. Okay, so earlier I also talked about the E vowel. It's the A vowel too.
Yeah.
That's the ah, ah, for anybody singing. For anybody singing.
Yeah, it doesn't matter the
easiest
language.
Way. You don't want to go, oh. No. There's a lot of ways to do the ah vowel.
Oh, yeah.
Like, ah, ah, ah. Listen to this. Ah, ah, ah.
Yeah.
It's a huge, there's a huge difference from a little bit. In your a little bit of adjustments,
yes.
There's just a huge difference. So if you really want to learn how to do an A vowel, you need to listen to CT.
Absolutely.
Okay. Groupings of five is a thing.
Yeah.
That we don't do a lot in Western music.
No.
And ba da 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 da.
Yeah.
Da 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 da. It's so good. Bum 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 bum.
Right. So it's like we have triplets, which is a grouping of three.
Yeah.
But like really, you're right. We don't really do that.
We don't do really groupings of five.
Because it's still, because the rhythm for this is like 6/8, probably. 6/8, 1/2/3/4/5/6, 1/2/3/4/5, 1/2/3/4/5, 1/2/3/4/5, 1/2/3/4/5, 1/2/3/4/5, 6/1/2/3/4/5, 1/2/3/4/5, 6/1/2/3/4/5, 1/2/3/4/5, 1/2/3/4/5, 1/2/3/4/5, 1/2/3/4/5, 1/2/3/4/5, 1/2/3/4/5, 1/2/3/4/5, 1/2/3/4/5,
so you do five notes in the span of three beats,
yeah, right?
Like eighth notes. It is so good.
It's and really
it's
cool.
So fun, and it's really cool.
Yeah, I also want to talk about where she's sitting in her range right here, and like just kind of hanging. Right up there, it's really like vulnerable, I think. And she's singing, you know, when you have consonants, a lot of times you can hide behind that. Mm-hmm. They help you kind of spring off and make sound. But it's a lot of vowels. There's a lot of vowels that I'm hearing. So, you know what I mean? Like, that's a super vulnerable thing to be doing vocally. And she's just kind of doing it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. A lot of performance is making what you're doing look effortless.
Right.
Look easy.
Right.
And you can tell that this is a little bit of a tricky spot in her voice.
Right.
We can't, you know, can't tell that because she's not doing it amazingly.
No.
But just because it has a sound where it's approaching that flip where her voice would naturally flip up into head voice.
Yes.
And she's just doing it in such a way that makes it look like, you know, you're just
so
having
easy.
Fun. It's easy. All that kind of stuff. And that's honestly what makes that's a really wonderful thing in performance.
Yes.
Is seeing that somebody's just having a good time doing their thing.
Absolutely. And enjoying themselves. Yeah.
Jiwa hanya
Okay, your face is making me wonder if you're thinking the same thing as I am. So it's hard for me to know if something's out of tune.
Sure.
Because I don't know the tonality. Like, obviously, all of the accompaniment seems like Western.
So that's exactly actually what I was thinking. Tune. So I was thinking about the pit.
Right.
Right?
Yeah,
the orchestra. So what instruments, the orchestra. What instruments are in the pit? We just saw like a drum. But then I also saw a little MIDI keyboard.
Right, exactly.
And MIDI keyboards, you know, you can program to do anything, but they still are limited to those 12 tones.
Absolutely. And I think you hear like even string instruments and stuff like that that don't sound like they're tuned differently, at least from what I'm hearing.
And unless you have frets on those, like a guitar, you could play really anything.
But I think it's funny because part of me, there's a few things happening. The way she's singing, so like that natural relaxed throat where it's kind of like that yodely flip thing, is a really difficult thing to sing in tune, right? Because you're jumping from the different parts of your register, and it can get really heavy, especially if you're doing like a descending line or melody.
That nature of keeping it free,
absolutely,
too, makes it hard to have that ultra control. Where you jump and land on.
It's all
notes.
On your ear and your mm-hmm. knowledge and your like your sense of tonality.
Yeah.
So that's one thing.
And this is like a stream of multiple. Songs.
Exactly. But then the other thing that I'm wondering, because there are so many microtones happening, is it even ever really out of tune actually? Because it's just foreign to my ear,
sure.
right? It's just actually, sure. I'm not used to hearing those notes.
And that's actually a conversation. We had a whole lecture on this in a class I took called World Music.
Yeah.
And that's like, you know, imagine taking all the music of the world and putting in a semester. You don't even scratch the surface on any of these. But that's the discussion, is that,
right.
like, is something out of tune, or mm-hmm. is it a different tuning system entirely?
Entirely, yeah.
You know, that's what brought me back to thinking of the orchestra.
Right.
It's like, imagine there's a Western, or, you know, you have Western style
instruments,
players.
Oh, right. Absolutely.
Players, where let's say all the strings players are from Europe.
Oh, exactly.
You know,
right.
they're from Europe. And
right.
so they're playing regular mm-hmm. half steps and whole
right.
steps.
Right.
But like other instruments in the pit
are
native to the musical style.
Well, you obviously have both going on at the same time because you have her singing, right?
Yeah.
So her singing is already, and like the melody fits within a scale, it seems like.
Mm.
It's just everything in between it. Like, it's just there's no note off limit in between, but it does still feel like you land at certain points. Like, there still feels like a tonic.
I really hope you're right that they call that you said that the scales are called melee.
I think it is, or something like that. Yeah,
I love that.
Me too.
That.
Me too.
This I'd is love yeah. to learn about that. You know, I was when we were doing a bunch of songs in like the Indian style.
Right, right.
I loved learning about ragas.
Mm-hmm.
And it made me watch more like sitar players
mm-hmm.
and learning about the talking drums and
yeah.
all that kind of stuff was so cool.
It's cool.
Yeah.
It's really cool.
Yeah.
This isn't offensive. I hope this is like duh, but this it reminds me of Bollywood.
Oh, really?
Yeah, because Bollywood is like, it's like theatrical
and it's fun.
And it, but it's also like the scales seem similar.
Sure.
That I think the scales are some. I mean, there are similar like parts of the world, like Asia.
Well, I mean,
great, like greater Asia.
Western culture is
right.
from Europe all the
right.
way over to the United States,
right.
and so that's like kind of half the world, honestly.
Yeah.
You know, even in South America and
mm-hmm.
Latin America, you know, the scales
right.
are still kind of whole steps and half steps.
But I think there's also influences too, like when you're. Again, I'm not trying to say that like Malaysia and India
are
like
the same.
But I think that you're going to have influences when you're in the relatively similar hemisphere
yeah.
of the world. But
sure.
the other thing is, like, I would love to know, you guys can let us know in the comments, is this, I know this is a medley, but is this like a medley of songs that you listen to on the radio or songs that you like hear at home or songs classic, she's known for.
Classic folk songs.
Yeah. You know? Like it seems theatrical in a way because obviously they've got like a set and a stage. Bunch of dancers. But like, are they, is that like maybe just the arrangement? So I'd just be really curious to know that.
Totally. Yeah. Yeah. I don't know. I love that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
Her, one of my favorite things that I want to point out from a vocal technique perspective is I'm going to back up real quick. And I want us to watch her neck.
Okay.
And shoulders. Neck and shoulders. All of these muscles here are really intertwined. Mm-hmm. If you tighten one, they all start to get a little bit tense.
Right.
And so that's, you know, what one of my goals as a singer is to keep it loose.
Right.
Keep it active. You know, if you watch athletes, they're active and they're using their strength, but they're not tight. Mm-hmm. And that's an important distinction.
Right.
So, you know, watch her chest, watch her neck.
Yeah.
And she's just so loose.
Relaxed.
Chin, you know, this kind of stuff is where a lot of people get tight as well. It's so easy.
Yeah.
And it's so smooth.
Yeah. But there's a lot going on.
Yeah. She's moving all over the place. Yeah. And she's dancing. And she's and she's breathing. So it's like, it's just really impressive.
That's really cool. Yeah. That's really cool. So sorry. Talking about the like the vibrato, at least that style that I hear, it sounds almost like, so like our vibrato doesn't really have different pitches, but it almost sounds like the style is like a vibrato with different pitches. Do you know what I mean?
Sure.
Like it's like to us, like when you sing with a vibrato in a Western style, sure there's gonna be like like a minor.
It's not as big.
It's not a very wide gap, but I feel like just in this first line.
I would say that it is different pitches, but I agree with you that it's not as wide of a gap.
Yeah, and so
it's almost a full half.
Exactly. It's a super unique interval that makes it sound very that's what this is.
We would,
you know what I mean?
Train that.
Yeah.
We would train that in our classical training at school, and it was a trill. It was it was an actual thing where you're trying to hit a different note.
Yeah.
And it's
right.
You know, where you're really trying to get that wide gap.
Yeah.
But it was like an active thing that we were doing, and it wasn't throughout the entire piece.
Right, and this seems stylistically like kind of like the go-to. Like that's just what you're doing.
Which is another amazing thing about different cultures'
music
from different parts of the world, is that something as simple, you know, at the time when I was in world music, it was unbelievable to me that other cultures would have different tonal like systems.
Yes.
You know, something to me that was like in tune or out of tune.
Right.
That's that's objective. That's what everybody hears. No,
right.
That's
not
what everybody hears. In our sense of harmony, our sense of tonality is literally different.
Right.
And I think that kind of stuff is really cool. So this is another thing that
Absolutely.
Is like to me something that would be so, you know, normal or regular across the world as vibrato.
Right.
It's not.
And that's kind of just like an observation, I think, when you listen to it, that's kind of what's happening, don't you think? Like, it's not this like intentional, I'm singing all of these notes.
Yeah.
It feels like that's just where the voice lies in the scale and tonality of this kind of music.
It honestly just makes me love the voice more.
Oh, 100%.
Because it's just, to me, is one of the most versatile instruments in the world.
Yeah, it is.
You know, we can do anything with our voices, and that's a wonderful, wonderful thing.
That is really cool if you think about it. Like, you couldn't play a piano in a different scale, but you could sing your, like, your voice in anything.
Well, you could play in a different scale, but you have to tune it.
You'd have to change the instrument.
Instrument, and then you can't go from one to the other in no time at all.
No,
you
know?
With even within the same song, imagine that. Like, instead of a key change, we're going to have a complete tonal system shift.
Modulation. Wow.
I love it. It's like,
The voice is cool, guys.
The voice is so cool. We did this thing in our choir where we stopped using the piano entirely. Because the piano is called tempered tuning, where they give an average of each note. But the voice can adjust these microtones to get into even more, like,
perfect tuning
than the piano can.
Yeah.
And that was so fun. And it actually really worked well for our choir to sound even better, because we weren't singing the notes that were being played on the piano. We were tuning to each other.
And listening. Like one instrument.
Like the gamelan.
Nice. Just tied it right in there.
Is that those melismas, that those little up and downs of the microtones, are almost another dimension to phrasing.
Absolutely. You know,
when I think of phrasing, I think of things that I can do to do a phrase.
Right.
Okay, I can have volume. I can change my voice quality a little bit. You know, if I want something to sound breathy or whatever, to kind of convey a little bit of emotion. But that's kind of it, you know? These are like little tail ends, and like, not to say that there aren't melismas and stuff that we do.
No,
but it's almost adds another layer to these phrases.
Absolutely.
That it's just really nice, and it kind of communicates more.
Oh, absolutely. And I wonder too, like, I know that if we knew the language, it would help us understand like how they're being added.
Yeah.
Because
unfortunately there are not subtitles on this video.
But not even that. Like, I just think like if you knew if these things are happening like at the end of words, in words, it's just like you said, it's just another layer to add to like the artistry of it, right? Like the communication of what you're trying to convey. That's really cool.
Yeah.
That's really cool.
I think it's something that's unique to what I'm hearing in this music. Yeah, that's really cool.
Yeah. Harmonica? Accordion. Strings or MIDI? Probably strings.
Wow.
That's pretty cool.
That was awesome.
Wow.
That was such a marathon, too, singing. You know, we both did recitals in college. And it's, you know, it was a good solid 45 minutes of singing.
Yeah.
And it's not easy.
No.
And for her to go back to back to back is just tough.
Yeah, she's absolutely. Awesome. No, I think that not only do we love hearing like different tonalities and stuff like that, but I think we just love that it showcases how beautiful the voice is and how dynamic the voice is as an instrument, because it just shows you that like we can really do about anything we want to with our voice. And that's really cool because I don't know. Listening to Fozia, she adds a little bit of that into some Western contemporary pop music, which is like...
Well, but I also think that last song had a lot of Western
style. But that's
style,
what I'm saying,
like,
yeah.
You know, she was... The melody that she was singing had a lot of those melismas and stuff. But the things that everybody else was playing was very 12-tone kind of music.
Yeah, it's really neat. And I kind of love, I definitely love the marriage of the two. I think that is, I mean, we run out of ideas after a while. I mean, we'll never run out of music. But I think that getting...
But I think that's the tough
combining
part
things, yeah.
Is when you only have 12 notes to work with,
exactly.
You start to use the same ones over and over
again. There's only four chords, you know.
And a lot of our music.
So. Yeah.
So a special thank you to Mohammed for sponsoring this video.
Yes.
If you would like to sponsor a video just like this, go ahead and check out our website. There's a link down below. If you like this video, please give it a like. And if you're new here, please consider subscribing. We make new videos like this every week. We're Chase and Melia. We'll see you soon.